40-watt circular tube. If you have seen a 40-watt circular tube, it's about 1 feet in diameter. In Singapore market, you can get the fluorescent one, but you cannot find the LED ones. The LED ones stop at only 32 watts, which is smaller. I got a problem because I fixed that one. I've got a mirror in right smack where the 32-watt light will be. If I do shopping online, I have found it, it's $57 for the LED ones. I'm not prepared to pay that money. So I say, okay, let's make my own. And this is what I've done. Want to make a wild guess how much this setup would have cost?
$10.
Okay, $10, anybody else?
$8.
$8, anybody else? Okay, each of these bit, I bought probably about 5 cents each. And they are about 96. This one cost me only about $2. So all is actually less than $10.
The driver is less than $2.
The driver is less than $2. Okay, you get in Singapore is about $5 to $10. I got this one in China, 10 of them. Each one is about $2. Okay, being an engineer, I usually will not just stop there. I'm also quite curious how this driver works. So this is a circuit for the driver. If you notice, the red things are actually the additional component. The black one is actually the IC. So the bulk of the thing has been strung into one IC, and the IC is actually the 18 IC. And the other thing I was quite curious, the whole thing is actually two MOSFET. And the two MOSFET has no heat sink. If anyone of you has used a MOSFET, this one, each one is about, it can take, okay, rated for each of the LED is 1 watt. I've driven it to about 1.7 watts and it still works. The strange thing about the LEDs, it doesn't like constant voltage, it likes constant current. Up to about 1.6 volts, the LED will not light up. Around 1.7, 1.8, you'll start to be very visible. Around 2 to 2.5, you have quite decent light. Beyond 2.5, it starts getting very bright. But if you look at the voltage hardly moves. So around 2.5, if you look at the current and voltage, your voltage moves a bit, your current moves a lot. When I'm hitting about 3.1, the current is almost 1 ampere.
Oh, you're 3 watts per diode.
You can, although this is rated for 1 watt, you can actually drive this very hard.
Oh,
okay. So I don't want to destroy it. When I reach about that current, I actually stop. Anyway, it's way too bright for me to take it.
It's not 1 ampere for
LED.
LED. 1 ampere.
So these LEDs can take a lot. Because I'm not using heatsink, most of the LEDs they actually built on the aluminum base, so those can take a bit more heat. Any other questions?
How do you choose a driver?
Okay, the driver basically go by wattage.
Yeah, actually that's something I have been quite confused about recently, because I'm seeing a lot of drivers that just give wattage but no.
Okay, you need two things. You need wattage and voltage, because there are two variations of the LED configuration. You have the 12 volts one and the so-called the high wattage one. The 12 volts one, what they do is actually three LEDs in series and then everything in parallel.
The one is already CCS inside.
Okay.
The driver is already built to CCS, constant current source.
Yeah.
So that's how you get your wattage, right?
Okay, when I'm doing the testing, I cannot use this because this one will not allow me to drive.
Right.
So I'm actually using an external power source to drive the LED to check. This one, no matter how you try to drive it, you'll be fighting the driver. The driver wants to keep it constant and quiet.
So you're saying your LED, so right now, would you know how many volts and how many amps is your...
You can calculate. Because your LED driver, generally, you are looking at between 200 milliampere to about 300 milliampere. So it will be stated there with the current. You can also adjust the current if you want to. There's a current sensing resistor. So you know where the current sensing resistor, you change that one. You can actually change the current a bit. But it's only also within a certain narrow range because there's a lot of protection circuit in there which will not allow you to go above a certain point or below a certain point.
Right now you're running at how many amps for the whole setup?
Okay, this one is currently about 200 and 20 million, 280 million. Okay, this one I'm running in a series configuration. I'm not running in the parallel configuration. I'm running actually the 48 in one series, parallel to another 48 in another series. So you can multiply out, it's about, you need about 2.8 volts. So 48 times 2.8, you have about 90 over volts across the thing. So when this is power, I will not want to touch the leads.
So actually your CCS ramps up the voltage.
Yes. So this one is a constant current. It does. It will ramp up the voltage to as high as you can, and there's a voltage range also.
Voltage requirement.
And because of that one, the driver usually will tell you the voltage range. And that will give you an indication how many you can connect in series. So this one I have is okay, this one is 24 volts to 9 volts. Okay, 24 volts, which means I need minimum of at least 10. If I do anything less than 10, I cannot use this driver.
Can you tune the current on this?
You cannot tune the current directly because everything is fixed. But if you want to, you can change this resistor to a potentiometer, then you can tune.
Actually, you should be able to get full control because it's a CFD. It's a current feedback amp, right? You should be able to get your full swing of power across the...
No, because that, like I said, the protection circuit is built into the...
Or there's nothing more than
your servo portion is actually limited because there's a protection circuit inside the IC. So you look at the specs, your range of adjustment is actually very low. Okay, this is a fairly new phenomenon over the last probably 4 or 5 years. Before that one, before this kind of ICs came about, you have to do quite a lot of discrete circuits. You start with a constant current one, all your protection is actually outside, not inside the chip. Over the last 4 or 5 years, they actually incorporated a lot of this protection inside the chip, and it takes away your flexibility of adjusting by a wide range.
Oh, because I think the reason is because they move output stage into the chip. They never had the ability to put one set inside the chip before.
Okay, one of the things I have tried doing, I was trying to do dimmable. You cannot do dimmable by adjusting your voltage because, again, your input side, this one is quite a lot, 85 volts to 265. So it will tolerate a very wide range of adjustment before your light will start changing.
Have you tried
dimming
through the balance resistor?
Okay, I have tried changing the balance resistor. The adjustment range is about 1.5 ohms.
Oh.
And it's very hard to find a 1.5 ohm variable resistor. And you cannot go to zero because you short the current sensing. The protection circuit will kick in.
Oh, it's really just in series with the LEDs, that means. So it's in series to output stage, yes.
Okay, so what it's doing is, your LED is actually in series with this two driver, and in series with your current. And what you're doing is actually tapping this one to measure your... to compare it to a voltage, to measure actually what is...
You can actually do a voltage divider across that, and divide that again.
Again, the other side has a limit of how much you can adjust because there is a protection system. Okay.